Hola, bienvenidos a la clase de español. Today we're going to give you a short story called El Crimen Perfecto by Enrique Anderson Imbert. It's one of my favorite short stories, and it's a good time of year to do that because we have Halloween and we're going to start talking about El Día de Muertos, the Day of the Dead. So here we go with the short story, El Crimen Perfecto. Su vida fue un novelista, escritor de cuentos cortos y crítico literario. Nació en Córdoba, Argentina, en 1910 y falleció en Buenos Aires, Argentina, en el año 2000. Recibió numerosos premios durante su carrera literaria. Fue profesor en la Universidad de Michigan y en Harvard. His life. He was a novelist, a short story writer, and literary critic. He was born in Córdoba, Argentina, in 1910 and died in Buenos Aires, Argentina, in 2000. He received numerous awards during his literary career. He was professor at the University of Michigan and at Harvard. And here we go, El Crimen Perfecto. Hope you enjoy. Quería haber cometido el crimen perfecto. Perfecto el plan, perfecta su ejecución. Y para que nunca se encontrara el cadáver, lo escondí donde a nadie se le ocurría buscarlo, en un cementerio. I thought I committed the perfect crime. Perfect plan, perfect execution, and so that the body would never be found, I hid it where no one would be looking for it, in a cemetery. Yo sabía que el convento de Santa Ulia estaba desierto desde hacía años, y que ya no había monjitas que interceden a monjitas en su cementerio. Cementerio blanco, bonito, hasta alegre con sus cipreses y pariosos arroyos del río. Las lápidas todas iguales, y ordenadas como canteras de jardín alrededor de una hermosa imagen de Jesucristo, lucen como si las mismas muertes se encargasen de mantenerlas limpias. I knew that the convent of Santa Ulia had been deserted for many years, and there were no longer nuns bearing nuns in the cemetery. White, beautiful cemetery, even cheerful with its cypress trees and paradise on the banks of the river. The tombstones, all the same, arranged like garden quarries around a beautiful image of Jesus Christ, looked as if the dead themselves were in charge of keeping them clean. Mi error. Olvidé que mi víctima había sido un furibundo ateo. Horrorizadas por el compañero del sepulcro que les acosté al lado, esa noche las muertas decidieron mudarse. Cruzaron a nado el río, llevándose consigo las lápidas y arreglaron el cementerio en la otra orilla, con Jesucristo y todos. My mistake. I forgot that my victim had been furious atheist, horrified by the companion in the grave who put them to bed next to them. That night, the dead decided to move. They swam across the river, taking tombstones with them, and fixed the cemetery on the other shore with Jesus Christ and everything. Al día siguiente, los viajeros que iban por la lancha al pueblo de Fray Bisco vieron a su derecha el cementerio que siempre había visto en su izquierda. Por un instante se les confundieron las manos y creyeron que estaban navegando en dirección contraria como si volvieran de Fray Bisco. Pero enseguida advirtieron que se trataba de una mudanza y dieron parte a las autoridades. The next day, the travelers who were going by boat to the town of Fray Bisco saw on the right the cemetery they had always seen on the left. For an instant, their hands got confused, and they thought they were sailing opposite direction, as if they were coming back from Fray Bisco. But they immediately noticed that it had moved and reported to the authorities. Unos policías fueron a inspeccionar el sitio que antes ocupaba el cementerio. Y cavando donde la tierra parecía recién removida, sacaron el cadáver. Por eso, a la noche, las almas en pena de religiosas volvieron muy aliviadas con el cementerio a cuestas. Y de investigación y investigación. Bueno, el resto lo sabía usted, señor juez. Some policemen went to inspect the site the cemetery used to occupy, digging where the earth seemed to have been moved. They removed the corpse. That is why, at night, the sorrowful souls of the nuns returned and very relieved with the cemetery in tow. And from the investigation to investigation, well, you know the rest, Judge. So this is the story. I hope you enjoyed it. He's at court telling his story.